Hello all, welcome to Instrukart Holdings, your worldwide instrument partner. Now I am going to walk you through the product SZ-7524P, Subzero Digital Temperature Controller. This temperature controller is a superior version of the previous temperature controller of model number SZ-7515P, which I explained you in the previous video. This temperature controller has a temperature range of minus 40 to 50 degrees Celsius. And compared to the previous Subzero SZ-7515P temperature controller, this temperature controller is having additional features like it is having two NTC probes. You can see here, this is one NTC probe and this is one NTC probe. And for cold room temperature, this is for cold room temperature and this is for evaporator coil temperature. And the previous SZ-7515P temperature controller has a relay outputs for only for compressor, but this temperature controller is having relay outputs for compressor, fan, defrost, and you can also see the terminals connections provided here. 1 and 2 are for power supply, 230 volts DC power, AC power supply, and 3 and 4 terminals are for room sensor and this is probe, and 4 and 5 terminals are for to connect the coil sensor, and 6 and 7 terminals are provided to connect the buzzer. You can see SZB75 buzzer, and these are the terminals provided for the outputs like compressor, fan, defrost, and this temperature controller comes with a housing of black ABS plastic, and it can operate under an operating temperature of 5 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees Celsius with a storage temperature of minus 20 degrees Celsius to 70 degrees for the same. And it is these NTC sensors are having a range of minus 40 to 50 degrees Celsius with an accuracy of plus or minus 1 degree Celsius. And compared to the previous SZ-7515P temperature controller, this temperature controller is having an additional feature of resolution change. For the previous one, the resolution is at only 1 degree Celsius, but for this you can have two types of resolutions, 1 degree Celsius and 0.1 degree Celsius. And you can see here, this is the 7 segment LED display, and this comes with a panel cutout of 29x71mm dimensions, and the mounting of flush panel mounting with the fasteners, and protection of IP65, in which the front panel is the waterproof. This is the waterproof one, and you can see here beside this display, these are having some keys to set various parameters. This is the set key to set the cutout point and or any other parameter, and this is to enter into the program mode, and this is used as a dual one in order to exit from the parameter, or in order for compressor and defrost on also you can use this, and acknowledge the buzzer by pressing this key. And now I am going to show you the parameters, how you can set various parameters in this temperature controller. Now it is showing the current temperature, which is sensed by this cold room temperature sensor NTC probe. It is showing 30. And coming to the parameters, you can set the cutout point of the controller by press and hold this set key for 2 seconds. You can set the cutout point of the controller here. You can see. It can be both negative and positive, and also be 0. And coming to other parameters, in order to set into other parameters, you have to enter into program mode. In order to enter program mode, you have to press this program key for 2 seconds, hold on for 2 seconds. It is showing P2. P2 parameter is to set the higher temperature limit set. I will set this higher temperature limit as 33.5 set. It is like auto off, automatically after some time it will show the current temperature. And now I am showing you the how this buzzer works. I will increase the temperature. You can also set various other parameters like lower temperature limit and for differential and other for evaporator fan. You can see that I increased the temperature so that it is giving the buzzer. This is to acknowledge the buzzer, and it is blinking as the temperature is increased. It will show the display as HT. Until and unless it will reach the current temperature or below the temperature of higher temperature limit, it will give the blinking. You can see this is the blinking for alarm. Alarm indication is showing. Slowly it will reduce the temperature. As I set the higher temperature limit as 33.5, up to 33.4 it will show the same display HT. Slowly it is reducing, you can see 33.6 here. And we can set the minimum allowable temperature limit by entering into the program mode. As it reached below the higher temperature limit, buzzer is stopped and it is showing the current temperature. And you can set the lower temperature limit in the same way by entering into program mode P3. In order to set the lower, you have to enter into P3 parameter set. This is the default lower temperature limit, -40, and you can't go beyond this as this is the minimum value set. This is you can also set the differential, which is the P4 parameter. Differential is nothing but if the set point is set at 10 degrees Celsius and the differential is set at 2 degrees Celsius, when the system reaches to 10 degrees Celsius, the compressor will shut down, and after as the differential is set to 2 degrees Celsius and after 12 degrees Celsius, that is set point plus differential, the compressor will again restart. This is to set the differential. This is the purpose of differential setting. P4 set 2 degrees. And coming to other parameters, like you can also set the probe calibration. Probe calibration is nothing but in the, you can see here. In order to set the probe calibration, you have to enter into P5 parameter set. Probe calibration is nothing but if the actual temperature is like 30 degrees Celsius, if the this temperature controller is showing 28 degrees Celsius, that is there is some failure in this probe. In that cases, you have to set this to 2 degrees Celsius, that is 30 minus 28. If I set to 2, then after it will show the actual temperature, which is 30 degrees Celsius. And you can also set the set time delay, that is which is between relay and restart time, and this is minimum of 0 minutes to maximum of 20 minutes. This is like if this parameter is set at 3 minutes, the relay will cut off at the set temperature. But if the As I was telling you before, this P6 parameter, this is to set time delay between the relay and restart time. if this parameter is set at 3 minutes, the relay will cut off at the set temperature as we said, and but it will cut off at the set temperature but will not restart for a minimum of 3 minutes even the differential is achieved earlier. That is the use of this parameter. And we can also set various other parameters like P6 is for differential, P7 parameter, this is to set the drip time for defrost water to drain out. Like this way you have to set. And P8, coming to various other parameters, P8 parameter is to set the compressor relay status on room probe failure, 0, 1 and 2 you can set. 0, 1, 2 set. And other parameters like power on frost delay, P9 parameter is used for power on frost delay. And P10, coming to L1 parameter is used when evaporator fan stop temperature is required. This setting is used to limit the maximum temperature beyond which the evaporator fan will cut off. This is the temperature set. And L2 parameter is used to set the time delay between the evaporator fan relay restart time. If this parameter sets at 3 minutes, the evaporator fan relay will cut off at the temperature set by L1 parameter, which is the previous parameter, but the fan will not come on for a minimum of 3 minutes even if L4 is achieved. L4 is nothing but fan differential temperature. And set, in this way you have to set. And coming to L3 parameter has a function when fan operation when compressor is off. If it is 0, evaporator fan is off when compressor is off. If it is 1, evaporator fan will stay on even though compressor is off. Set. And coming to L4 parameter is to set the evaporator fan differential. This is nothing like if L1 parameter is set to 2 degrees Celsius and this L4 parameter, that is this differential parameter, is set to 2 degrees, then the evaporator fan will cut off at 2 degrees and restart only at 0 degrees Celsius. And L5 parameter, coming to L5 parameter, this is to set probe to offset calibration, which is like probe calibration done for cold room in the same way for coil temperature, that is evaporator fan coil temperature. And coming to L6 parameter has a function when fan operation and compressor is off. L6, if it is 0, evaporator fan will stay on during defrost. If it is 1, it will off. And it also have various other parameters like to set defrost frequency. You can see E1 is to set the type of defrost. E2 is to set the computation for defrost, that is calculation. E3 is to set the defrost frequency. And E4 is to set the maximum defrost duration based on your application. E5 is to set the defrost top temperature. E4 and E5 are used mainly in defrost purpose. E8 is used in coil probe failure. AL parameter is used when power on time delay for alarm is required. FS is to restore default settings of the controller like the previous one. And this product, and you can also set various other parameters. This product comes with the instruction manual for operating purpose. And for more details and direct purchase of the same product and similar product, you can visit our website www.instacart.com. Thanks for watching.